01 car of Joey Carapaz, the Randolph Mass Insurance Circle Performance Machine. He, of course, on the outside of row number 4. My apologies for missing that fine competitor. The pace car pulls into the infield. We're about ready for the start, and there's the green flag. Is Kenny Bouchard getting a jump on Rick Miller as they go down the back stretch? But Jamie Obey picks up dividends on that one, and as he moves into the third spot, Kelly Moore runs fourth, Billy Clark fifth, Mike Rowe sixth, Bobby Gaeta seventh. Then it's McCabe at eighth, Carapaz ninth, and Shaw tenth. on the outside of Smith, moving straight on the back bumper of Bouchard. Flag of the race coming out on lap number 28 as Ken Bouchard spins out into the Riverside Motorsport in 233. We'll be looking for the Grand Prix pace car to go into infield. It does. And the green is out. And Jamie Olby is the leader of the band as they go down the back stretch in through turns 3 and 4. The number 60 of Dale Shaw. Kelly Moore all closed up to the back bumper of Jamie Olby. Dropping out of the race, and the green is out. Mike Rowe is going to work on Olby. Side by side, they are coming off of turn number 4, and it's Olby still holding on to that lead position. Mike Rowe not giving up in his pursuit on the outside, however, and he's pulled up side by side, inching out in ever so slightly. Outside route is not the way to overtake Olby. He's dropped back into line, and he looks like he's trying to see if he can find a move on the inside of Olby. Olby doing a fine job of protecting the inside of this racetrack as well. way through this race, with Jamie Omi on top, Mike Rowe second. The number seven car, a Billy Clark, runs in the third spot. 100 laps, 100 laps, the two-thirds marker of the 150 lapper this afternoon. It has been Jamie Obey showing you why he is the champion of the Busch Grand National North Series. As he is picking his way through traffic, Mike Rowe still running in second, Mike Weed in his third, Dale Shaw fourth, Billy Clark is in the fifth position. Dick McCabe runs sixth, Rick Miller seventh, Kelly Moore is up to the eighth spot. Third win of the season. Will it be Mike Weeden picking up his first? We shall see. And we have agreed. This time around, Obey, Weeden, and Clark running 1, 2, 3. Weeden looking for racing room on the inside. Obey shuts the door quickly. Decide your winner. Thank you. got anything in his bag of tricks. He'll have to show it right now. This doesn't look like he's going to do it. And Jamie Olme comes through turn four. Down on the start finish line, your winner, Jamie Olme. Two cars hooked together here off of turn four, and they are both going to make it to the start finish line hooked together. A marriage of sorts there between... Another win notched in his belt. A lot of them lately. Jamie, how'd the car go today?
Well, it went spectacular. It was flawless all day. It was just as fast at the end as it was in the beginning. The boys did a super job getting the Lake Murray and E.J. Prescott Buick to run this good down here. Haven't had a lot of luck here, but this sure paid off today.
Now, every time you got in traffic, it seemed like you had your mirror full of Mike Rowe and that... bright orange number 15 car. What'd you think of that?
Well, I knew Mike was running good, and Billy Clark, and, you know, Mike Wheaton, and there was two or three other guys that were running pretty strong back there. I couldn't afford any slip-ups.
But the car worked perfect, and nobody gave you too much trouble.
Well, Mike gave me a run. I mean, I ran the car flat out just about the whole race, so, you know, things worked out good. The car worked super.
A couple of guys trying you there at the end, including Mike Rowe and Mike Wheaton, but didn't seem to upset you at all?
Well, you know, we just had to hang on. We had a few laps to go, and Mike was probably running a little bit better than I was in the end. We ran her awful hard the whole race, and he might have conserved a little bit, but we had enough to hang on, so we'll thank God for that.
Congratulations again, Jamie Olme, our defending two-time Busch Grand National North champion. The winner of the Busch 150 here at Monadnock Speedway. He's going to go out and pose for a lot of pictures. Of course, Jamie's third win here on the Busch circuit this year. He's having himself quite a...